Jump in.
Come on, let's go have some kind of fun in this here.
I'm
today.
Hungry. Yes, Mesa.
Right,
yes, Mesa.
What?
Look. Have a coke and a smile, people.
It's raining a little bit, but I think the car air dried. God, this place is gonna be packed tomorrow. Is that Thomas's car?
Yeah, it is.
God, I'm like blasting Christian rock. Is it Bugatti here?
No.
Yeah, it is. No. I don't believe you. No? I wish. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
Great. Happy Friday.
Thanks. What's going on, guys? So we are here today at Symbolic International. There's a very special car on display. Now, this car came by our showroom on Tuesday by mistake, but as you guys saw in one of my previous vlogs, I actually recorded the car showing up, but only on the truck. But we have a few hours today with the car to do full video shoot, full photo shoot. Here's the car. I'm gonna do a little cinematic clip for you. Enjoy this. So I gotta say that I've done a lot of really cool photo shoots in the past with McLaren. When the 12C first came out, I shot the first two in the US. I've done some really cool shoots with different brands, but I gotta say that this car tops pretty much all of them being here at Symbolic International. Now, I used to work for Symbolic, and now Symbolic is strictly classic cars, but this is their main showroom here in Sorrento Valley. Just outside this building is where we hold all of our cars and coffee events, but honestly, this whole photo shoot, this whole experience has been one of the coolest to see behind the scenes, and to be able to see this car in person, the first one in the US, is just beyond awesome. So what I'll do for you guys right now is I'm gonna do a full walk around tour, give you guys more of like an in-depth look at the car. Check it out. These doors are extremely light too. And you can see all this dry carbon fiber throughout the whole door. You have the polished gloss carbon fiber on the door sill. Also right here throughout the entire car. Gives a really cool shadow look to it. Super concave steering wheel with all that dry carbon behind it as well. Similar style Veyron seats, but new stitching pattern. The Chiron on the headrest. And look how cool that is right there too. Now when you sit in the car, you sit very, very low. You almost get sunken in when you sit inside, but look how cool these buttons are. All the dry carbon throughout the interior. And look at that, 500. Very cool. Look at this right here. How cool is that? Talk about something extremely different too. Look behind you. Oh my gosh. Very cool. So we're turning off all the lights right now. We got Scott and Adrian here from Cinemotive. I'll put their link to their website and Instagram right there. We got, where's Grubbs? You here? We got Grubbs Photography here somewhere, so I'll put his link as well, but they're getting some cool shots. I just noticed this, check out the Chiron right there from the door. That's really, really cool. But they're gonna do some light painting and they kill it with video too, so I highly recommend check out their videos. But that's it for my video. Hope you guys enjoyed that. I have to go do some actual work to pay my bills, so hope you guys enjoyed it. Looks pretty sick.
Forgot a plate. Okay, you're on camera. Hi, say hi. Hi, Finn.
You were just energetic today, huh? Jeez, now my camera bag. What are you doing? Alrighty, so made it back to my office. I just pulled that G-Wagon inside of the showroom. Got all the photos on this guy right here. I'm gonna go ahead and edit these photos real quick. My boss wants to get them ASAP. And also, what I have to do is, for Cars and Coffee, what I wanted to do is give you guys more of an insight of like behind the scenes look. One of the cool things is that when I started here, I had the opportunity to have the show in my control. So basically what I would do is from start to finish organize the show based on like the logistics from like the coffee to the people to the event flyer to the Facebook page, pretty much everything that had to do with Cars and Coffee. So there's a lot of things that people don't see behind the scenes as far as what I do for the event, on top of also doing like the social media, the photo shoots, the event coordination, everything in between other than Cars and Coffee. So I want to give you guys an insight of what else I do. What I had just done is I'm paying for the coffee over the phone for Starbucks, and we have to go pick it up tomorrow morning. Organizing the logistics for all the vendors that we have coming, Nectar Juice Bar, Donut Bar, and some other companies that will be there. So we have to place them in certain areas, and the DJ too. Some of them have to have power, so we have to put them in different places. Trying to organize like a map of all my staff people that I need to have there, what time people need to be there, putting the cones out. There's everything that goes along with it. So in tomorrow's video, I'll show you guys a basic run through of how we do that from the start to the finish. And I'm gonna record while I'm running the event,
trying to get content for you guys, so I hope you guys appreciate all the work I put into these videos. I'm going to finish these photos right now, send them to my boss, and then get to work because I have a lot more to do today. And my M3, I can't wait to see it. It just got a wash in full detail. I can't wait.
They are in Australia, the Quattro, when it's all-wheel drive.
Oh, and they're gold?
Yeah.
There we go.
Oh, you could put this one on YouTube, huh?
Yeah, there we go. We can put this one on YouTube. That's
that right there. Okay, this is how we go.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. Yeah, over. Fast and the Furious, here we go! Oh my god. We're good now. Tony almost killed us.
I'm going to pick up my car now, though.
All right.
In the Lexus IS300. Kind of, I miss mine a little bit. I had an old school black one.
They drive good.
They're really good. Cars. They're pretty cool. So you sold it to your son?
Yeah.
He's driving this now?
Yeah.
Tony's off for the weekend. He doesn't work on the weekends. So I don't get to see him for 2 days. I'm going to be sad. 3 days. So I'm going to see
you. Oh, you see me Monday? No.
I don't think I'm going to be there Monday, dude. I'm going to be sad.
Don't work in the car business because you got to work on holidays.
You got to work a lot. That's true. I think we got to do a Tony Q&A soon. We'll do a bunch of questions.
Right.
All of everyone on YouTube comment.
All right.
So we'll do like, we'll tell people to ask you questions and we'll see what they say.
Have you guys asked and I will answer.
There you go.
There you go.
That's it. Get ready for a Q&A for Tony.
All right.
Oh, I see it right there.
There it is.
Oh, dude, it looks so good.
Yeah, we had to do it. We had to do a sick
one. We'll do a really cool one. Do some.
No, but seriously. I'll let you know. I'll keep you in touch.
Damn, look how crazy that looks. Wow, they got rid of all the swirls on it. Holy crap. Looks like a completely different car. Wow. I gotta say, Detail Shop pulling through once again, killing it. I mean, my interior is so clean. All the carbon, all the interior, the seats, the floor mats, I mean. Now, a lot of people question about this car. Everyone in every video that I post is always like, why is your passenger door painted? Well, the car was painted just on this side. It had a dent that could not be pulled. You can see here a little bit. But the car has a clean Carfax. It's just, they couldn't pull a dent right here. But it's nothing major. But after these guys literally spent the whole day on it, it looks like a brand new car. I'm so excited to take this to Cars and Coffee tomorrow. Holy crap. All right, let's go drive it. There's like one of those anniversary Porsches behind me with the old school Fuchs on it. I'm trying to shoot my car somewhere and I just got so lost. What's up, Dan Bilzerian's old house? Talk about a view. As you guys saw, I just got my car back from the detail shop and oh my god. The car feels so much better being this clean and they'll be a lot more presentable for tomorrow's car show. I was looking for a spot to shoot at and everything's kind of busy right now because it's 5:30. So I'm going to go to this parking lot where I actually shot my STI a while ago, about 2 years ago. And it's just a big open parking lot at a school. So I'm going to go over there real quick and hopefully I can make it in here. I was just looking for a big open spot and this was like the best spot I could think of. It's just speed bumps are kind of gnarly. This is the location, but it makes for a good open area. I just want to get quick pictures before the car gets dirty.